just over 29 years ago when I was traveling in Australia, I ran into a couple that was on their way to a Christmas camp, and they invited me along. I thought it would be a good thing to do because I thought I was a pretty good Christian at the time. I lived a moral life. But there was something more that I saw there. They opened up their Bibles and they showed to me that when people received the Holy Spirit, back in the early church, they spoke in tongues. And I knew my Bible pretty good at that point. I could get around it pretty good. But I couldn't find anything to refute what was being shown to me in the Bible. So I was baptized by full immersion. And that was the day after Christmas of 1989. And on January 1st of 1990, I was in a prayer room all by myself. And I received the Holy Spirit, and I know it because I spoke in tongues. After I received the Holy Spirit, I was sitting there in the room all by myself, and I just said, "Lord, what next?" And the last 29 and a bit years have been what next. There's been all sorts of challenges. When I moved to Fresno 20 years ago, I got my 20-year watch, so I know it's been 20 years. I started work for this company. They were looking for somebody who knew something about accounting and something about Canada. I was a pretty good fit because I've had probably 6 or 7 different jobs while I've been with that company, but I've been with that company all through it. And you know, things come up and hit you from the back sometimes. Sometimes you see them coming, sometimes you don't see them coming. And you can get really upset with the Lord about how your life is not going the way that you wanted it to and how you had it planned. Or you can just simply rejoice that this is the day the Lord has made. And that's really what is getting me through every day, is to just rejoice. Get up out of bed saying, "This is the day the Lord has made. I'm going to rejoice and be glad." And when I forget to do that, the day goes bad. When I remember to rejoice in the Lord gives me a good day. And I just really need to praise the Lord for that simple rejoicing that He gives me no matter what. And I really look forward to rejoicing in the Lord till He returns. And then when the Lord returns, knowing that every day, every moment is going to be rejoicing with the Lord, right there with me. And I just really want to praise the Lord for that. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jeff. Just knowing every day we have to rejoice.